Cause you don't know nobody else that's gonna come through and see like that. And make sure you okay. Baby, are you okay? Let me know now if you're okay. Text call if you're okay. Hey guys, welcome back to Star TV. On today's lovely episode, we're gonna be talking about a very controversial topic. We're gonna be talking about why it seems that most men hate and resent women. Right before we get into today's lovely episode, if you're new here, make sure you subscribe to Star TV, where you get a new episode every week. Make sure you guys like this video. As you like this video, YouTube pushes it out more to be seen. So if you rock with me, if you like me, if you feel in the videos, if you love these topics, these discussions, before it even starts, make sure you give it a thumbs up and make sure you hit the bell down below and press all so you will be notified each and every time Star posts a new video. Let's get right into it. So if you guys have not known, I did film a video about a few days ago, and I was talking about, you know, the rape and the murders of so many women across the globe, and how if you are a woman, you are under attack and you need to use caution and be safe and, you know, 10 steps ahead everywhere that you go. So this is where, you know, I always knew it, but this is where it kind of really sunk in for me that a lot of men hate and resent women. Okay, most men are justifying the rape and the murder of women across the globe out of bitterness and out of envy. You have a lot of men out here who have had bad experiences with women, bad experiences with Black women, Hispanic women. So when they see, you know, that women of these nationalities or just women in general have been violated, have been murdered, have been assaulted, they justify it. They feel that it's okay because they've had a bad experience and maybe they felt played, or maybe they got their feelings hurt, or maybe now they have low self-esteem where they want to see every woman destroyed, where they feel like women have to pay for what another woman did to them. That's the kind of world we live in, and now it makes sense. It makes sense why our men are not being real men. They're not helping women. They're not protecting women. They're not taking up for us. They're not riding for us, because they truly believe that women deserve the short end of the stick. You know, being on YouTube, it made me to realize that no matter what you do, no matter how positive you are, no matter how, you know, bright you shine your light, people are going to come with the negativity. People are going to have something to say. People are going to, you know, what do you call that? They're going to twist your words. They're going to hate you. And that's okay, because the love is greater. And YouTube showed me, you know, the mentality that a lot of these men have. You're okay with, you know, young girls being raped and murdered at the age of 12. You feel that, you know, women deserve that because maybe you were rejected. Maybe someone wasn't interested in you. You know, maybe you got your heart broken. So now you want to see other people hurt. You feel like other people need to pay for the mistakes of someone you were once dealing with. It's not right and it's sad. And you got to be a cruel person to justify this. I just want to shed some light, you guys. There was a young girl by the name of Yasmin Williams, age 31. She graduated, had her degree, was getting ready to pursue her career. This took place in New York a few weeks ago. There was a man who shot her in the head, right? And he was paralyzed. He was in a wheelchair. He packed up her body, dragged her body down the street in a trash bag, and left it by all the trash on the block. I'm gonna insert the video.
We begin with exclusive new video in the murder investigation of a woman found dead inside a trash bag in Kipps Bay.
It comes as police have charged a man in connection with the killing. Right now, he has not been arrested for the murder, but for concealing a corpse. CBS2's Lisa Rosner is live outside the police station in Kipps Bay with that new surveillance video. Lisa.
Well, Christina and Dick, that video just adds to the pain of how casually Yasmin Williams' body was tossed to the curb. Police tell us that 55-year-old Chad Irish could be facing more charges tonight.
Exclusive video shows a man in a motorized wheelchair casually dragging what appears to be the same trash bag that 31-year-old Yasmeen Williams' lifeless body was found inside of, wrapped in a sleeping bag. Friday, police responded to a call of a suspicious package on 27th Street between 2nd and 3rd Avenues. The medical examiner ruled it a homicide, saying Williams was shot in the head. The spot where she was discovered, now a growing memorial.
Yasmeen was really a caring person. She was energetic. She knew people around the neighborhood, so she was very loving. So it's pretty sad.
Tuesday, members of the NYPD crime scene unit went to collect evidence from the apartment of 55-year-old Chad Irish, who now faces one count of concealment of a human corpse.
Rest in peace to this young, beautiful girl. She was a beautiful light, but most of all, she did not deserve it. And you know what's even more sad? You got men out here who will see this news clip and still feel like, oh, that's what women deserve. She probably did something crazy. She probably said something disrespectful. You know, you got men out here with that type of mentality, and men like that are not for women. Men like that hate women and they resent women. So listen, ladies, let's not be so flattered by the compliments. Let's not be so enthused because a lot of men want to talk to us. Some of these men are wolves in sheep's clothing. Some of these men are not for us. They don't like us. They hate us. They love when we get violated. They love to see us on the news. You know, and it's so sad, like Tupac said.
And since we all came from a woman, got our name from a woman, and I came from a woman. I wonder why we take from our women, why we rape our women, do we hate our women? I think it's time to kill for our women, time to heal our women, be real to our women. And if we don't, we'll have a race of babies that will hate the ladies that make the babies. And since a man can't make one, he has no right to tell a woman when and where to create one. So will the real men get up? I know you're fed up, ladies, but keep your head up.
Our woman anymore. What happened to that 90s love? What happened to that love, you know, back in the 40s and 50s where people were married for 30 and 50 years? What happened to that? Where did, you know, our generation go wrong, and how can we revive that? How can we bring that back? I'm gonna tell you guys like it is. It's gonna take the work of God. Let's get into tip number two. This is also how I realized that most men hate women. A lot of men want to abandon their provider role. There's, you know, this thing going on social media where a lot of men, they complain, you know, all women want, you know, is money, but, you know, they don't do anything for themselves. They don't have anything. I would never want to do anything for a woman if she can't provide, also if she can't give her half. And let me tell you something. A lot of men like to bash us because we're women. We like nice things. We like, you know, nice bags, nice clothes, you know, expensive shoes, five-star restaurants. But you want to be real? You want me to be real with y'all? That is how God made women. That is how God created us. We are, you know, we are like beautiful butterflies, you know, if that makes sense. We like nice things. We like to dress up. We like to look nice. We like to go out to five-star restaurants. We like expensive things. A lot of us, we love jewelry. We love shoes. We love clothes. We love beautiful vacations. And, you know, we, most of us want to live a very beautiful, expensive, and luxurious lifestyle. We want to be pampered. And that's how we are, because women are loving. Women are nurturers. Women take care of the home. You know, a woman can build up her man, speak life into her man, cook for her man. You know what I'm saying? A woman should be a man's peace. We are nurturers at heart. That is what we like. In order to get those nice things, of course, we have to love money. Money is the exchange for those nice and beautiful things. But as for men, God has made men to provide and to protect. You guys not only build the home and protect the home, but you provide for the home. So as a man, I don't see, you know, why a lot of men contemplate and go back and forth saying they don't want to pay for the first date. If you are interested in a woman, right, You want her time. You want to get to know her. Step into your provider role without complaining and pay the tab. Pay for the bill. Take her out. Buy her nice things. It's your job to win her over. She has the prize. Being a provider is not something men should run from. It is you guys' responsibility to pay, to provide, to protect. You're supposed to be the strong man in her life. You know what I'm saying? You don't see women, or, you know, maybe some, but you don't see majority of women saying, oh, all he wants me to do is cook. Oh my goodness, why doesn't he get in the kitchen and try to cook something? We don't care, because that is our role. We have a nurturing role. We keep a home, but you guys provide. So I realized that men hate women when they're complaining about paying for a date, when they are complaining about spoiling a woman, buying her flowers, buying her nice gifts. You guys really must not like women. You know, it's hard for you to buy her flowers. It's, oh my God, the world's ending if you have to pay for a date. You're being cheap, you know, to your own family members. What happened to the men that work hard and give? What happened to the men who invest in their women? What happened to the men who want to see a smile put on their girlfriend's face? What happened to the men who, you know, feel that boost of testosterone when a woman needs them, when they have to take care of her needs? What happened to the men that feel good to pay a bill or two? They feel good to help their lady out. Why are men abandoning their provider role? It's simple. A lot of these men are resenting women. They're hating women, and they're only in it for one thing. And they want that, just that one thing, and they don't want to spend. And I'm not saying it's an exchange, but everyone has different motives. What happened to how it used to be back in the day? What's wrong with this new generation? We're justifying murders and rapes. No, not we're. Men are justifying murders and rapes of women. They don't want to step into their provider role when they're pursuing a woman. They want her to pay for her own plate. They want her to pay, go half and half on a date. Now, I can understand if y'all been in a relationship for a while. Then it's like, yeah, you know, that's your man, that's your boo. You could go half and half. But when you're first pursuing a woman, she should not be touching anything that looks like a bill, especially if you're working for her time. Let's get into tip number 3. Men who abuse and physically put their hands on women consistently to the point that they are building a track record. Listen, young ladies, when a guy wants to get to know you, when he wants to talk to you, when he's introducing himself to you, you have to do your research. I'm talking, you got to go through his social media. You got to, you know, see if you could talk to people that know him. You have to get the background on him. You got to do a history check, a background check. Because nowadays, you never really know who people are. A lot of people are pretending in the beginning. They got to put on the Mr. Nice Guy act to win you over. A lot of these men, you know, they have so many skeletons in their closet. They're not upfront. They don't tell women, you know, their full story, what they've been through, who they are, you know, what they're working on, what their true intentions are with you. Women, we learn that with time. But God gifted us with intuition, or you may be a young lady, you know, such as myself, that has the gift of dreams, where you can meet a person and God gives you a dream and you wake up, you're like, okay, all right, that ain't it. I'm not going to talk to him no more. God show me that ain't it. I trust the dreams. You may have that type of anointing, but listen, men who hit women, their wives, their girlfriends, that's not a man who loves you. That is a man who hates you. You marry someone, you're in a relationship with someone, a young lady who you know you're stronger than, it doesn't matter what comes out of her mouth. How dare you put your hands on her? You're hitting her, you're punching her in the face, you're striking her, you're destroying her home. What kind of man are you? And if you have children, what example are you setting up for your children? Your young girls, when they grow up, they're going to be scared of men. They're going to be scarred. They're going to think, you know what? Well, I've seen, you know, what happened in the household coming up. I don't want that to happen to me, so let me stay away from men. You're going to, you know, really damage and traumatize your children, because if you notice, most people who grow up in domestic violent homes, their children see that, and then their children get into domestic violent relationships. I don't believe men who hit women and abuse them truly love them. You have to hate a woman. You have to hate her in order to beat her. You have to hate her in order to take her life. Let me tell you, there was this beautiful young girl, you know, back in 2017. Her name was Toni Nicole Wells. From New York, she lived in Brooklyn Crown Heights with her husband, and she was also in a physically abusive and violent relationship with a narcissist. And looking back, you know, it's so sad. The man who claimed that he loved her took her life at only 22 years old.
Murdered 22-year-old Toni Wells had family members and neighbors who cared about her enough to call 911 for her. But now questions surround the initial police response Wednesday morning when the young mother's body was found with bruise marks around her neck at the bottom of a flight of basement stairs in a Crown Heights apartment building on Sterling Place, where Wells lived with her husband of 9 months, 29-year-old Barry Wells, and a toddler daughter. The 2-year-old inside their apartment was loudly crying, and that's what alerted this neighbor who declined to give us her name. She called 911.
Once you hear somebody child crying, you will go check, because the neighbors, we live in the same house.
So you went and you checked, but there was no adult answering the door? You just heard the baby behind the door?
Yeah.
She says she found the body.
The officers that came when I called 911 did what they had to do. I don't know about anything before that.
It was after her 911 call that police found the body and tracked down and arrested the husband, Barry Wells. But when an earlier 911 call came in around 8 Wednesday morning, the two initial responding officers may have dropped the ball. That's,
you know, and it's just so sad and unfortunate that you see situations like this so common and all across the world. We got to stay away from men like this, women. They don't deserve us. They don't appreciate us. And, you know, I feel like women, we are pearls, we're jewels, we're rubies, you know, we are beautiful butterflies, and we deserve to be loved and appreciated and cared for. Anyone who is tearing you down mentally, physically, and spiritually, that is not the man for you. And I know a lot of women, you know, feel that it's so hard to leave, but you have to choose life, and you got to know that life goes on. It ain't over. And you have to learn this lesson. Just because people leave you, it does not mean that your life is over. Let's get into tip number 4. You got to be real careful of men who always have that conquer mentality, or that, you know, if you reject them, they look at you with a certain look, or they talk to you after that with a certain type of tone, and you could sense it, that they have this "you will pay for this" mentality. Because men like this start to plot and plan against you. And I even experienced this. You guys, I know I come on here and I'm smiling, I'm positive, I'm giving advice, and a lot of people may think, you know, oh, her life must be perfect. She's young, she's pretty, she's so smart, she's full of wisdom. I'm from New York. I grew up in Harlem, then I moved to the Bronx, but I spent more years in the Bronx than in Harlem. I've had some encounters. I've had some experiences. Let me tell you guys, there are times where my life could have been taken. There are so many instances where I could have been on the news, like all of those other girls that you guys see. If you see Star still standing here, it is by the grace of Almighty God. You got to be careful of men who approach you. And when you give them an excuse because you don't want to hurt their feelings, and you tell them, oh, you know, I have a boyfriend, sorry, or, you know, you just flat out honest, I'm not interested. You watch when their demeanor changes. When they see you again and now they have an attitude. Now they're giving you an evil stare, a glare. Now they're following you and you don't know why they're following you. Now, you know, you see them and they got two other men with them and they're all following you down the block. Be careful of these type of men, because men who, you, let me share something with you guys. I was walking in my complex, right? And there was this man, and I was coming home from work. This was yesterday. He was like, hello. And at first I wasn't sure who he was talking to, because the sun was, it was glaring all in my face and I'm trying to get home. I'm tired. I've been at work. Them kids driving me crazy. I love my babies, but they be driving me crazy sometimes. So I'm real tired coming home. Gotta walk the dog. The man says, hello. I'm not sure if he's talking to me, so I stay silent. And there's a box on the ground. You know what he does, you guys? He kicks the box so hard with the attitude, all because I didn't reply. And this made me realize that men who have that what you call that switch. They go from, you know, how can I say it, inviting to evil and angry. You got to be careful for those type of men. They have that you going to pay for this type of mentality. Similar to the young, beautiful girl, I might insert her video here, Mia Marcano. Let me share her story, you guys. She went away to college. It was a maintenance man who was pursuing her, texting her, wanted to have a relationship with her. She was not interested. I believe she tried to, you know, just be cordial with him. She worked in her college and he also worked there. So she was cordial with him, kept it professional, tried to be a little bit friendly to get him off her back. And then ultimately she turned him down. And because of this, he became very evil and vengeful and plotted against her. And he had that same mentality that you're going to pay for this mentality. And what did he do? He hid in her college dorm. She was supposed to fly home that day. Imagine coming home in your college dorm and someone is hiding in your closet because they're the maintenance man and they have the key fob to your apartment. And you walk in and someone rapes and murders you in your own dorm and they hide your body in the woods. Be careful of men who have that you're going to pay for this mentality. You turn them down, they get angry, they get violent, they get rejected, they start kicking boxes, they don't know what to do, they don't know how to manage their emotions, they don't know how to remain calm, they lose it. A lot of these men grew up without fathers, a lot of these men, you know, don't have good relationships with their mothers. They don't care what happens when it comes to a young girl or a female. Until it's their mother, until it's their little sister, until it's their cousin. I had a young man in my comments on my last video that I made about women being under attack. He said, why should I help, you know, a girl? Why should I help her? What am I getting out of it? And he also stated, you know, the darkness is going to come, you know, out of me. You're going to see. Another person commented, the only thing that can save a woman is if, you know, a man restrains himself. Listen, girls, these men are getting out of hand. Start getting your pistol license. Start getting your firearms. Start going to the range. If you got to carry a knife, do what you have to do because they're out to get us. I'm not saying all men. You have good men out here. But the ones who are bad, they're not going to show us no mercy. When they're plotting and planning to launch attacks against us, you know what they do. They take and then they throw you away. There's a war on women. And I don't expect men to be on my side. I don't expect men to come in the comments and take up for me or to be like, yeah, sis, you right. You know, y'all ladies, y'all go through a lot. I don't expect that. But one thing I do expect and one thing I love is that the women who watch my videos are with me. This is an all-girl empire. We have to protect us. Forget about what they're saying in the comments. Forget about, you know, the viewpoint of these men because they're the one launching the attacks. It's time that we become safe. It's time that we protect ourselves. Get your pistol license. Get your gun. Do things the right way. Take a martial arts class. If you gotta hire you a private security guard to follow you from a distance, if you have to run an errand late at night or, you know, in a certain neighborhood, do what you have to do. I don't want to hear nothing happening to no other young girl ever again. This is a cruel world and we got to be safe. Well, you guys, this is Star TV. I love you guys. And until next time, Star will see you soon. Peace.